Have you ever wondered how to check your pH or EEC? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it.
Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. We got our $2.99 membership, and we have a VIP if you need a little more one-on-one, link down in the description.
Okay, Mr. Range, this was absolutely a great question I'm going to get into. I think all of you guys are going to really love this video. How do you check the PPM and the EC? Sorry, I'm a new grower, just soaking up new things. Alright, so I created actually a couple different scenarios for all of you guys that I think it doesn't matter if you're a new grower or a seasoned grower, I think you'll be able to pull something from this video. Okay, so to answer this question really quickly, how to check your parts per million or your EC, you have to go get purchase a meter. Okay, so let's go ahead and dive into these scenarios. So you have your feed, you've already put in all your nutrients, all that stuff, and your pH is 5.8, your EC is 1, or your parts per million is 700. So an EC of 1 is a parts per million of 700 on a chart. And you are going to go ahead and feed your plant 1 gallon of nutrient feed. Okay, so the runoff comes out at 7. Your EC is 1.5 or 1,050, and you recollect a half gallon. What is the pH and EC of the grow media, right? Okay, so you're putting in 5.8, but you're getting out 7. So what is that? And you're recollecting a half gallon. So what does that mean? That means that this 5.8, even though you collected a half gallon of runoff, your pH of your soil was probably like 7.5. And your EC was when you recollected it was 1.5. So normally when you are feeding your plants one EC, you want your runoff to be somewhat a reflection of what you're feeding your plants. So if your pH is 7 and your EC is 1.5, what do you have to do, right? Well, what I would recommend doing is probably mixing up another gallon or two, set your pH at 5.6. I'd probably reduce your EC all the way down to probably 0.5, because as you can see right here, remember, we want the EC to be a reflection of what you actually wanted to do. So your EC would have been 1. And if it's coming out at 1.5, we don't want to put 1 in there, because it will take longer for those salts to redissolve and flush back out. Also, your pH is 7, and if you already ran a gallon through and a half gallon came out, that means if you run 5.6 through your grow media, most likely that next gallon or two it's going to take to bring this pH all the way back down to probably 6.3 roughly. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at your next one. Your pH is 5.5, your EC is 0.5, you run 1 gallon through your grow media, your runoff is 6.3, your EC is 0.6, and your recollection is 1 ounce of water. So what does this all mean? And should you continue to keep feeding your plants to get that ideal 5.8, right? For me personally, I wouldn't. You know, 6.3 is a perfect healthy range. Your EC is a reflection of what you're feeding. And when you recollect, you're only collecting 1 ounce. But as you can see, even that one ounce, it's a reflection of what you're feeding it. So personally, I would probably leave that alone. And then let's say we come over here. So your pH is 5.8, your EC is 1, your runoff is 5, and your EC is 1, and you recollected a half gallon. If the pH is 5 on runoff, what does that mean with half gallon of recollection? Well, right here, just as what we did over here, having to add more pH down to fix our pH issues and to reduce our parts per million, right over here, we're having our EC be a nice reflection of each other, but our pH is off. So what we're probably going to want to do on our next gallon is add the same amount of nutrients, do exactly what you did, but probably increase your nutrients to 6.5, 6.8, and then go ahead and feed your plants. And what you're looking for is that your runoff to be, once again, at least 5.8 to 6.3, and your EC, once again, being a reflection of what you're feeding it. Remember, guys, what we're looking for is that nice growing environment in your growing media. And so often when we set the pH of our nutrients and our EC at a certain amount, we're expecting that to be the same thing at the end of the runoff. That's why it's so important to check your runoff. And if it's not a reflection of each other, you have to do some chemistry a little bit of math and get your growing media back into that homeostasis. Okay, so I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you understood how to check your pH and your parts per million in your soil growing media so the maximum amount of minerals are bioavailable. Just as a side note to this too though, is remember, if you go over too much on your parts per million or your EC, you will shut down your microbiology. So there's two relationships, right? You have your microbiology that goes and retrieves and processes the nutrients, but then you have your minerals and you have the ideal pH range for your minerals. So when you combine these things, so you have the ideal pH range and then you don't overfeed your fertilizer and you allow your microbiology to exist, these two things can begin to work together and have the minerals because they're in the right pH range and the microbiology because they're not all dormant because it's not too high of a parts per million or EC, can begin to create a co-relationship and begin to work for you in your soil media by creating a soil food web. Okay, thank you so much. Please give me a thumbs up. Hope you guys have a beautiful rest of the day. Bye.
Question. I was at my local hydroponic store the other day, and the guy behind the counter told me that ammonium nitrate makes these plants taste bad. Is that true? Short answer, in my opinion, I would say yes. And this is why.